debit card, some proof immediately. And after few years, if they just prove that they are human beings, immediately they will be given a loan. Like that, it is known as a deficit financing. Deficit financing that gives you ill returns or procrastinated returns or bad debt. So this financial stagnation is due to the deficit financing levels. And there are some monetary factors and non-monetary factors. What are all the monetary factors? One is a high level of investment. High investment plan or huge investment plan, number one. The investment of government on huge non-developmental activities like defense, etc. Defense, they are spending millions of crores over decades. At this Sri Lanka border, this Jammu Kashmir border, these things are unavoidable. But there are a lot of other measures also. They must simultaneously go for all measures. So these things are known as non-developmental expenses of government. Huge non-governmental expenses. Number two, huge investment plans. Number three, huge indirect taxes that is offered by the government. Fourth thing is black money. Whenever there is black money sources you to purchase more property, to spend it lavishly, to get into the society for more things. If you get for more things, as the production is not evenly more, there will be more demand, less supply. So the prices will hike up. It is the reason for inflation. So each and every member of the society, normal person, they suffer. Normal persons for food and other movements, they suffer. And high person, they also suffer. These people suffer for water, these people suffer for orange juice. That is the difference. So it is a common suffering, depending upon the need, the level of luxury or level of urgency or necessity of people they used to suffer. And also there are other non-monetary things. Six things have been given in the recent survey. And it starts with population. What we can do with population? It is a totalitarian study, demography. One person must do that. So it is population. Second thing is the calamity, natural disasters and other things. And the third thing is, it is corruption. And the fourth thing is the import prices, hike in the importing prices. And the fifth thing is monopoly. And sixth thing is utility of resources, either manpower or resources. Our India, now it has, we have utilized only the manpower as well as the resources, only one third. One third of the national resources have been used. And only one fifth of the manpower that is properly used. Lot of people are uneducated. Lot of people are very honestly serving for other countries. Most of the people are very lazily serving their own families. And other people are interested in immoral trafficking and other various other antisocial activities like smuggling and other things. So the manpower of the society has been diverted, dilapidated and diluted in various that is exoproductive, non-productive, improperly productive and infra-productive forms. So this is the reason for this recent economy. Now the RBI, they have announced, now the RBI, that OIB Reddy, he has announced that we are going to bring it back to 5%. And according to Shastra, it is told that we need some heat. If a person is too chill, he is dead. We need some temperature. And if a temperature exceeds a limit, the limit of security, then only we have to rush to the doctor. Normal heat, whenever a person works, he will have heat. Any developing country, according to the recent developmental economical status and survey, India must healthily have 6 to 7% of inflation. He told that he will bring it to 5, but 6 to 7% of inflation, that will always create an urgent demand in the society to work for more produce and other things. It is very reasonable. These fellows, they are not understanding. For just either consoling the people or for making the people their ever dependents, there somebody is saying that they will bring it to 2% or 1% or zero inflation. It is not going to be healthy to the society. A reasonable inflation is very much required. It is very much essential for the society. And the Shastras used to say two things. Stapyatam, establish everything. For example, if you save 1,000 rupees today, you can purchase 1 gram of gold. But you just to put it as an ideal saving for 10 years, where you are going to purchase the same gold for 2,000 rupees per gram, then the purchasability, what is inflation? Inflation is defined in economics that it is the lack of constant purchasability value of money. We can purchase anything by money, but constant purchasability value of money is lacking in inflation. That is not inflation. Likewise, if you are just ideally saving something just for security, you are going to lose money. That is, savings is a process of protection, but long-term saving is a process of loss. Because if you are saving money today, and if you are going to make it as an inert saving, and the same money, after 2 or 3 years you are going to purchase the same commodity, the commodity price will be more and your mix will be the unit value of your currency automatically. So productive investment, there are two types of productive investment, which is known as investment for interest. Second is investment for returns. And whenever you are investing for returns, you must invest in certain areas where the rate of inflation will be lesser than your rate of returns. So you must not think that inflation itself is better than our investment. So we must invest in such an area where there is a sturdity. So here, there are a lot of people we have now groomed inside the stock exchange. We can classify them into some groups. One is mega companies who are in the safer zone. What is known as safety zone? Even the whole world is perishes, they won't suffer. Or they will suffer, the suffering is like ant bite. So they are known as mega zones. They are known as safety zones. And persons, those like Tata, Birla, Ambani, those who have reached those zones, what they will get is lesser profit. There are a lot of things which you used to say, that it is the green area, the pale green area, the pink area, the pale red area, the red area, the grey area, black area. These are all the areas which you used to say in Shastras to identify the fiscal position of a company or the monetary status of a person. So if a person is fertile with more resources, that is green. Sufficient profit, abundant profit, unlimited profit, limited profit, sufficient profit, little bit, that is a trivial profit, then profit, then a person's investment is safe, he is getting trivial loss, sufficient loss, exorbitant loss, total loss. All of these areas are there in that zonal map. Likewise, in the investment, these mega companies are there in the safety zone. They come under the first thing. Second thing is the rulers are the predominant measures which are taken by these people, those who monopolize the stock exchange. They are in the second level. Then in the third level, there are calculative investors, those who know something about the stock exchange, and limitedly those who invest, and they are very much interested in short selling. Immediately they want to sell. See, there are two types of instincts within the stock investors. One is avarice, second fear. Whenever the prices come down, immediately they will get fear that it will come further down, so immediately it will be sold. So whenever the prices go up, immediately they will get on avarice that it will further go up, then immediately they will purchase. These things are not there. There are also a lot of transient mode that we say in stock is transient mode. Sometimes it will appear that it has been increased or decreased, then it will be re-stabilized and organized. This type of understanding must be there. So these type of people are calculative. Fourth type of people are very safe. They are just consultants and advisors. They will just give you points and give you some ideas. They won't get into the risk of these things. So they are the safer thing. Fifth thing is aspirants. Aspirant means they are interested in stock. Everybody is doing share market business. Everybody is doing stock exchange. Why can't we do that? You see, this is char, that is share. What makes the difference? I will do that. So I want to get a larger amount of wealth resources in a very limited frame of time. The only way, that there are some other ways. Getting into politics, and second is getting into media. Third is printing our own currency, and fourth is getting into share. So one among the very limited resources for getting more wealth within a limited frame of time is this share market, which is very legalized but not organized and systemized, but very legalized. It is not a taboo or it is not against the policies of a government. So everybody is interested in that. They are known as aspirants. So these the safety zone companies and the mega investors, the calculatives, consultants and the aspirants, the basic investors. We are all having lot of such people here. So for these people, immediately what we can do, and I already told that in global resources we cannot touch our hand. And also I have already told that most of the financial irregularities are due to the black money that is handled by the common people of the society, the well-established people of the society. So the people have 30% of the flaws within themselves and the government has 30%. The nature, it has hold the other one-third, the final one-third of these things. What we can do is, in spite of all of these inflations, there are also some sturdy organizations. Wherever we have assets, lot of other companies are there, they have proper assets. And the second thing is, they have perennial demand for products and services in the world. They are evergreen in their products and services, number two. Number three, even if something occurs to the global market or the global geopolitical or economical crisis, they are capable of stabilizing themselves. and such company has competitive value always in the market, number 4. Number 5th, that company